Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Storm Adventure Time, and my name is Storm. And today I decided to tell you a little bit more about transport around London. I've been thinking to do this video for such a long time, and finally I am doing it. I've been living in London for 6.5 years now, and in September it will be 7 years, so I've been traveling a lot around London. If you've been watching my channel, you probably noticed that. And I thought I will share a few things about London travel. At the beginning, when you just come to London, it might seem very, very overwhelming with 11 underground lines, for example, and all those different ways of traveling, like underground, overground, buses, DL, trams, riverboat service, Emirates, airline. It seems so much and so confusing at the beginning. But once you actually get deeper into this, it's actually really, really simple and very convenient. I will mainly talk about the service which I use the most because I know them the best, and the ones which might be the most useful for people who come to travel to London, and most likely they will not need to use all of them. To be honest, I personally on my daily life use underground, buses, DLR, overground, and pretty much that's it. I would start with underground because this is what probably a lot of people would be using on a daily basis. As I said, there are 11 underground lines. I would say the most tricky one is Circle Line, because at the beginning I used to get on the wrong train, so make sure you are very careful and you check directions. Every station before you go to the platform will have a map, so you can check which direction to which station the train is going. So make sure you check that before you go to the platform so you get on the right train. It is really simple to do it. Pick up the little map at the station. It's really, really handy. You will definitely find the use of it. At the stations, you will always have a notice board with all the train times and directions displayed. It's very, very rare that underground platforms would not have it or it wouldn't be working, so in most cases you will have that information. For the underground, you would need to make sure that you touch in before you enter through the barriers. It doesn't matter if they're closed or not, especially if they're open, make sure you touch in and you touch out. The main reason for that is that if the gates are open at the time when you're coming, it doesn't mean that they will be open at the station where you're leaving, and vice versa. So make sure you touch in and touch out, because what will happen if you just touch in or only touch out is you will be charged a lot. Meaning a lot, you will be charged the maximum possible amount, and it's quite expensive. Because transport in London is a little bit expensive comparing to other countries, what I've noticed. It is really easy to recognize the stations because they will always have underground roundel, and underground has a red circle, so it's really easy to recognize it. It will have a station name, so you definitely won't miss it. And in central London there are plenty of them. Next very, very useful transport is buses. They are everywhere, and to be honest, if you're coming to London, it's one of the London symbols, those double-decker red buses, so it's kind of a must-do thing if you're coming here, so definitely don't miss them. The main thing that you need to remember, which is really easy, you only need to touch in. You don't need to touch out when you're getting off the bus. So with buses, it's really simple. At the beginning, it might look a bit confusing how to get on the right bus, where they're going and everything. In central London, you might be lucky and pick up the map with bus routes for central London, but it is very hard to find one. So I wouldn't rely on that, but every single bus stop has a map. Every single bus stop has what routes of the bus are going, and has information of the direction of the bus, and it has a very handy map with bus routes of the area with all the bus stops marked, and then you just check on the list and direction where you're going to, and you see on to which bus stop you need to go. It's really, really easy to find it. And then another thing to remember about buses, you need to stop them. So at the bus stop, just make sure you wave your hand to the driver to stop the bus, and when you want to get off before the bus stop, you need to make sure you depress a stop button in the bus, so otherwise the bus might not stop unless there are people waiting at the bus stop who want to get on. So you need to make sure that you remember that. Usually the buses have announcements for the next bus stop, so it should be quite easy to travel. Another service which I do use, especially if I'm going to Greenwich or Canary Wharf, is DLA. Because this service is only in Southeast London. It's really, really cute train service, which I made a video especially about it a while ago, so I will leave it linked on the screen so you can check it out. One really important thing to remember about this is that there are no gates. In most stations, you will not find gates, but you need to remember to touch in and to touch out. So you need to keep an eye for these machines and to make sure that you touch in and touch out. So keep an eye to see them. They're definitely in every single station. There are a lot of them. And another thing to remember about DLA is that unlike underground, which is kind of one line goes one direction with a couple of exceptions that has several branches, DLA has different branches, and you need to make sure that you know where you're going and which is the final destination. So check on a map where you want to get and which direction the train will be going and from which station, because you might need to change sometimes. But once you get it, it's really simple. Just check on a map. They are very, very handy, and as I said previously, just pick up one at the station. You will find it in any. So the next service, which is out of zone one, is Overground. And I don't use it that much. I mainly use it to get to places like Kew Gardens from where I live or Hampstead, because it just, the route works for me. But it's mainly just around central London. So if you're only visiting London and you're here to sightsee, you might not be even using it. But take a look at the map and see, you might find it useful. It works exactly the same as underground. You need to touch in, touch out, and that's it. Okay, one more service which is available in London is tram. It is in South London. It's around where zones 3 and 4 are, I believe, somewhere in that part. It's priced exactly the same as buses, because you could even get bus and tram travel card. But to be honest, I haven't figured out how the touching in and out works, because I think you might only need to touch in, but I haven't figured that out, just to be honest. I've used it once and I hardly ever go to that far to South London, so I would suggest if you're coming to London and you do need to get to South London and you will be using it, just ask any staff at the station and they will help you with figuring this out. If you need to touch in, if you need to touch out, how that all works, because I found it a little bit tricky and I definitely got overcharged for that travel. Another, I would say, a fun service in London, and that is mainly central London, however there is some in east and west, is riverboat service. So the ones which are included as part of Transport for London, where you can pay this the same way as you pay for underground buses and so on, would be river buses operated by Thames Clipper Company, and you can find the route online and the prices. To be honest, I would say it's bit pricey, but obviously you would be able to avoid some crowds, and also it's quite a fun experience in my opinion, and I think it's obviously less used than other methods of transport, so you might want to consider this option. And the last travel option is Emirates Airlines. So that is a cable car service which goes between two stations, and that's it. It is in East London, it's quite far, and to be honest, Londoners don't consider that as a real transport. I visited it once and I will leave that video on the screen, and I would say it's very, very touristy. Because when you're going on the cable car, you actually have a recorded audio explaining you the history of the area in London. So I think it didn't work as an actual transport, it became more as a tourist attraction. So if you're interested to see it, you're more than welcome to go and check it out yourself. The views are lovely when you are going above the Thames. Alright, so now let's talk how you can pay for traveling in London. So there are several options. You can use your contactless card. So that will have a little symbol like this at the corner of your card. If you're from overseas, check if your card would work, because from some countries, certain type of card will not be working, unfortunately. So just check on the TfL website. I will leave the link in the description box below. The next option is to get an Oyster card. And I think that is a really lovely option, especially that if you get lucky and you get a limited edition one. I had one for the Olympics because I moved to London in 2012 September. However, I was really sad when I lost it a few years later at night and I couldn't find it on the way back to the station. That was really sad. But a classic Oyster card looks like this. It's a blue Oyster card, and that's something that you can get at the station very easily. Then you can top up the card in the machines at any station and use it for payments. So start by tapping your Oyster card on the yellow circle, then choose the amount you want to add on the card, and then make a payment. So you can pay by a debit or credit card, or you can pay cash as well. And then once the transaction is done, tap your Oyster card again on the yellow circle. And that's it! Your card is topped up. And also, if you added your card on the mobile device like Apple Pay, Google Pay and so on, the full list will be in the link in the description box below, so you can use as well your mobile device to make payments. My suggestion is, if you're coming to London for a longer period, like at least 2-3 days to sightsee, I would suggest to use either your contactless card or get an Oyster card instead of buying travel cards for the daily travel cards. Because to be honest, getting a travel card is more expensive than daily cab or paying pay as you go. And that's, to be honest, for zones 1 and 2 is nearly double the price, because a daily cab for contactless and Oyster cards is £7 and daily travel card is £13.10 at the moment when I'm doing this video. So that's why I would suggest to take a look at the prices and consider what is the best option for you and for your trip. Also, one thing very important to remember, buses will not take cash payments. You can only pay with Oyster card, contactless card or your mobile device. That has been quite a few years, so please make sure that you are ready to make a payment on the bus using one of those methods, because you will not be able to make a payment in cash. And finally, how do you know which stations you need, which bus stops you need, which route is the best to take, when to change, and so on, when the bus is coming? Because not all the bus stops have a timetable where you can see in how many minutes the bus is coming. So there are a few websites and apps which I highly recommend and I use them all the time. So the first one obviously would be a TfL official website where you can see all the prices, you can check the maps, you can check this. How is the service? Because sometimes the lines are closed, especially on the weekend, so you can check if any line is closed, if there are any delays. You can check the route, how to get from one place to another. So that is a website which is a must to know if you are traveling in London. Next is Google Maps. So Google Maps is amazing because it will show you exactly from the place you want to go, even if it's your hotel or the Airbnb or the place you're staying or the place you're visiting, a cafe, anything, your location, how to get to the bus stop or the station, which train or bus you need, what time it's coming, how many stops you need to go, if you need to change, where exactly you need to change, if you need to walk, how far, where you need to walk, and so on. So it is really, really handy and useful. I use it all the time, even though I live here for such a long time. But London is really big city, and even though I know routes, which I'm using all the time, but I'm still using it because it's really handy. Next app, which is really, really amazing if you are planning to take buses, is Bus Time. You can check when the bus is coming, where exactly it is right now, and even to check directions from one stop to another. You can save your popular bus stop. I love it so much because unfortunately not all the bus stops have times displayed when the bus is coming, so I use it all the time, sometimes even before leaving the house, for the routes which are not so frequent, so I can check, is it worth going now or should I wait for a bit longer? Because if the bus is coming in half an hour and for me to go to the bus is just 5 minutes, what's the point going now if I can wait for a bit? So that's definitely what I recommend so much. And last but not least is the app which I recommend for anyone who is moving to live to London. It might not be useful for people who are just visiting, but if you're moving to London, I do recommend downloading TFL Oyster and contactless app, because you can make payments for your travel card or top it up through the app, and in half an hour time you just touch it in at the bus or at the station and the money is on your card, so you don't need to queue at the station at the machine to make a payment. You can top it up on the go and it's really, really convenient. I just love it because I can do it on the go. Alright guys, so that's it what I had to tell you about the transport in London. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments below and I will be happy to answer them. And if you would like to see more of my videos, please like this video and also please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of my future tips, tricks, bullet journal, and travel, of course. So I will see you next Sunday. Bye!